television, and it's just for women. It's the Women's Care Program at Desert Springs Hospital, a total health care service that provides you with your own personal physician. And if you're new in town, or you don't have your own doctor, establishing this relationship now is especially important. You'll enjoy free nutritional seminars and programs with expert counseling on diets and how they affect your life. Have full membership in our exercise studio with classes for both beginners and the more advanced. Stretch, prenatal, and aerobic classes are featured as well. Our patient education center is yours to use, making available to you information on a variety of healthcare topics, all of special interest to women. In addition to your hospital bills being discounted up to 20%, all of these other services and benefits will be available to you also. Total health care just for women at Desert Springs Hospital. Operators are standing by, so call now for details. See how easy it is to become a member and receive complete professional care in one convenient location. The Women's Care Program at Desert Springs Hospital.
KBBU, TV5, Henderson, Las Vegas.
Frog, out of here right now. Come here. Get him. Get him. Get Fred. Get him out of here. Told you never to bring him into my room. Out.
Okay, Mom. Can I have some pancakes for breakfast?
Tommy, it's a school day. All right. Just put Freddy in his house, okay?
All right.
Tommy, come on. The bus. Let's go. Pass it. Come on.
Wait!
I forgot two things.
A lunchbox.
Right. And?
Mm-hmm. Come on.
You have a good day. Bye-bye.
Thank you. idea about staking out the arcade. You're right about the drug traffic there.
The captain didn't think it was such a great idea.
That's because it came from you. Chen, he's always going to be on your case. You know that.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Come on. Let me buy you lunch.
Okay.
You want
one? No, thanks. I thought you quit.
I did.
When did you start again?
The day after Ellen and I got engaged.
That says something.
So I'm a little nervous, weren't you?
Oh, boy, I was terrified. I was 17 and so naive. I didn't know what I was doing or why.
Did you love him?
Well, he was the first guy who ever asked me out. He was the first guy who really liked me. So I married him.
Somehow I can't believe that.
Well, that's true. Anyway, that was a long time ago.
Think you'll ever get married again?
Yeah. If I meet the right guy.
Yeah, Jen, well, there's something I have to talk to you about.
Yeah?
Unit 210, 415F, Family Disturbance at 235 South Valley Drive.
What's that nut that was giving Manfredi and Harris such a hard time? 10-4, we're 3 minutes from the door.
Here we go.
Open the door, we're police officers. Open up, we want to help you.
I can't take this anymore.
Hold it! Get out of here! This is between me and my wife!
All right, get out of here!
Hey, what's his name? Bob! Okay, Bob! Bob! Listen to me! I know you're feeling bad, but this isn't gonna help. Now, your wife and your kids are frightened. You don't want to scare them. Now, come on, put it down. We'll work this out together, okay? Just put it down.
She doesn't understand anything! All she ever says is, did you get a job today? Did you get a job? Why doesn't she understand? Does she know what it's like out there? Why don't you tell me if you're so smart? Why don't you tell me?
Okay, I understand. And so does she, okay? She's just worried, that's all. She's just worried about the kids.
You don't think I'm worried about them?
I know. I know. But you two have to get together and work this thing out. Now, if you talk to her, you'll find out that she understands. Come on, Bob. Just put it down. Honey? Honey? It's gonna be okay, all right? I promise, okay? I need some help, you know? Gonna happen again.
So why didn't we just arrest a bum?
That's not the kind of help I'm talking about, Chris.
Jennifer, can't you leave anything up to the social workers?
By the time they get around to it. Come on, we gotta go to work.
Wait, Jen, there's something I have to talk to you about.
Well, can it wait?
Not really. Ellen's gotten a little uptight about us working together so much.
That's crazy. Now, she knows me. Can't you talk with her?
I guess she's just nervous about getting married.
Do you want me to talk to her?
No. No. I don't think that would help.
Well, tell her to quit worrying.
Jen, look, I'm real sorry.
You worry too much. Everybody decent?
Who wants to know?
Funny.
Yeah, come on in.
Shut up those showers.
Oh, Bill.
What are you looking at? Oh, kind of nice, huh? What do you think?
Not bad. Don't you think her legs are a little large for her body? Lieutenant.
Hello there. How's my favorite officer?
Well, I'm hanging in there. How you been? I haven't seen you in ages.
Well, I've been kept pretty busy at the academy. Say, listen, we have a couple new young ladies going through training right now.
Well, that's good news. I could use a little more female companionship around here.
I'll second that.
Officer Oakes.
Sir.
I better be going. Nice seeing you.
There's been a request by Officer Sands for a new partner. The request is granted. You'll ride with Officer Valana. That's it. Get to work.
Jen, it's just until we get married, and I'm sure she's going to come around.
Save it, Chris.
I'm sure there are a lot of places you'd be right now than in this car with a new partner.
Women.
Excuse me?
I don't know who to be angry at. The dopey's marrying or him?
Just kind of a bum rap.
Kind of.
Well, I'm... It's nice to meet you.
Have called 395.
How come I haven't seen you before?
Bad luck, I guess. I've seen you. I've heard about you, too.
I'll bet. What did you hear? That I was a sex machine or a lesbian?
Not on a Friday.
I heard you were a good cop.
Oh. Unit 210, 314 at the arcade, 3618 South Main, hospital 930.
10-4, we're on our way. Let's go.
Take it easy, guys. Okay, we'll take
this here. Possession and resisting arrest.
This is the guy who was selling at the arcade, huh, Jennifer?
I think so.
Take this guy in, will you, Stanley?
Nice work out there.
Thanks.
Officer Oakes, you got a minute?
Sure.
I was wondering, maybe you'd like to have dinner sometime.
Oh, I'm really sorry, but I don't go out with cops. Especially my partners.
I don't blame you. I don't either. Maybe there's a
chance you change your mind.
I promise I won't wear my uniform. We can pretend.
No.
Oh, come on, give a guy a break.
It's too difficult. It's just something I don't do.
I don't give up easily. I'm gonna keep trying.
Good night.
I'm gonna keep trying.
Woo! Oh, hello, Jennifer. Over here. Oh. Hot though, huh?
Mm.
Yeah. Did you see her?
Can you imagine having a body like that? I mean, she had beautiful...
Everything.
Yeah.
No, she didn't. She wasn't that great.
Well, you don't have your glasses on. Look, long legs, good thighs. Maybe in my next life.
I bet she's a rotten person. This is so hot. What's it supposed to do anyway?
Relax you.
No, it's only one thing that relaxes me. Oh, that exercise class was torture. I can't believe that's supposed to be good for you.
Well, if you do it more than once every 6 months, it wouldn't hurt so much.
No, nothing will help my thighs. It's a terminal condition.
There's always the police academy. Ooh, they'll get you into shape.
I think I'd rather have cellulite. I don't want to talk about my thighs. I want to talk about you. I thought you said you'd never go out with a cop.
Well, I know, but he was so persistent.
Oh, he must really be out for you.
Oh, it's been so long since a man's pursued me like this. It makes me so nervous. And he is my partner. You know, I could be making a big mistake.
Oh, Jennifer, don't be nervous. It should make you feel great. Besides, it's all right that he's your partner. It just means that you'll see him more.
Well, a lot of men think that a woman in a police uniform isn't sexy.
Well, then that's all the more reason to go out with this guy. Is he cute?
Oh, he is.
Oh. But is he single?
Of course he's single.
Does he have any friends?
Well, what happened to Jack? I thought you liked him.
Yeah, I do, but Jack just wanted a casual relationship. I just can't do that anymore.
I know what you mean.
So where's he taking you for dinner?
Some Italian restaurant.
Jennifer.
What?
Is he Italian?
I don't know why.
Oh, Jennifer, I hear they make wonderful lovers. You've heard that expression, Italian stallion.
Sissy, cut it out. I don't know what's gotten into you today.
Oh, I don't know. All this heat, or all these bodies, or all this talk about Italian.
How about an amaretto?
What is it?
It's an after-dinner drink. Trust me, you'll love it. Larry, two amaretto.
Are you Italian?
Yeah, why?
I just wondered.
I want to ask you a question, but I don't want you to take it the wrong way, okay?
Okay. What is it?
Why did you decide to be a cop?
Well, I decided I needed to support myself and my son Tommy after my husband left us. And I took a job at Lawson's factory, and I hated it. Then one day, I heard the police academy was accepting applications. I just decided to go for it.
So how's it been?
Hard. I mean, there's tremendous resentment towards me. Because I'm a woman.
But you had to know there'd be some resistance to a woman on the force.
There is another woman, you know, Lynn Adams. And I thought it would be difficult, but I wasn't prepared for how intense the feelings would be or that they would last so long.
Well, do you still like the work?
I love it. I never thought I'd grow up to be a policewoman. I still get a kick out of it every time I think of it.
What did you want to be when you grew up?
A movie star.
What happened?
One day, when I was 16, I looked in the mirror and I saw this skinny kid with braces and no hips staring back at me. And I thought, well, Jen, you better face it. You're not going to be a movie star. What did you want to be?
I wanted to be a photographer. And I was for a while. I took aerial photographs for the Air Force.
Do you take pictures now?
Oh, yeah, every chance I get. I really had a nice time that night.
So have I.
Even though I pushed you into it?
Yeah, even though you pushed me into it.
Right.
delicious. I didn't know you could cook.
Cops make great cooks. Something you neglected to discover until now.
I could get used to this. I haven't had a meal cooked for me since I left home.
Yeah, I could get used to this, too. You look beautiful.
I do.
In fact...
What?
Check this out.
When did you get this?
Today.
How do I focus it?
Right here.
Right there. Okay.
What are you gonna do?
Smile. Oh, great. Okay, now, sit down. Now, a little more, you know, a little more sexier.
Sexier?
Uh-huh.
How's this?
Great. Okay, now, one more.
My turn.
I don't like my picture being taken. No.
Hey, this light. You look great in this light.
I can't do this. You're better at this than I am.
Look over here.
Yeah. Nick, you've had too much wine.
Not true. Turn the other way. Turn this way.
I feel so silly.
That's nice. Give me a little curve there.
How's that?
Oh, it's nice. Some shoulder.
Thanks.
All right, now turn around.
The other way? More shoulder?
Oh, great, great, great. Great shoulder.
Can America best the rest? Find out on the ultimate countdown of the world's finest hotels, restaurants, beaches, and resorts. The stars raise the flag for America in a spectacular two-hour extravaganza. It's a non-stop journey of excitement around the world in pursuit of excellence. Don't miss the sizzling showdown on the all-new countdown of the rich and famous 1987 World's Best. Can America best the rest? The verdict is near.
Don't miss this TV5 special, Wednesday evening at 9.
How much?
What do you want to pay?
$100?
I got $100. Do I hear $125?
At some discount stores, you have to haggle to take home a great deal. But at Silo, you don't have to because everything's on sale. Every TV, every VCR, every stereo, even every appliance. And you don't need to raise your voice or even your finger.
$175. Sold to the Lipton Lord for $200.
Let's go to Silo.
There's no sale like a Silo sale.
Boy, is this stuff hard and so boring. How can I find a job like yours?
Well, I trained at VTI Business Computer School. I learned word processing and all office procedures on a business computer.
Yes, sounds great, but suppose I go through this program and don't get a job offer.
No way. VTI has a placement department and they'll help you find a good job.
Karen, I'm sorry. We're computerizing. We don't need you anymore.
What was the name of that school?
VTI. Call now.
A short time ago, I was fired from this company because I didn't have the necessary skills. Then I went to VTI Business Computer School. I learned word processing and all office procedures. Now technology is not passing me by. I'm part of the computer age. If you'd like a career like mine, call the number that's on your screen. Call right now.
Hello, Karen. I understand you've been to VTI. Welcome back.
Call VTI. You'll be glad you did.
Presenting Mama.
Ta-da!
A woman of the world.
Relax, boys. You ain't got nothing I haven't seen before.
She loves her family.
Mama, Naomi doesn't understand why we still have to live in the basement.
Because that's where the drips belong.
And when it comes to laughs, her door is always open.
Mama, I brought you a little present.
See her every week on Mama's Family.
Tuesdays at 7, right here on TV5.
Is that your friend?
Well, here we go, about to begin another boring day.
It can't be Kojak every day.
Glad I'm riding with you.
You didn't say two words yesterday. You had your nose just tucked away in that photography book.
I was mentally undressing you.
I know you're nuts.
Nick. Isn't that Sam, what's his name? You know, he's an officer. I know his wife, and the woman he's with, that ain't her.
It's been going on for a month.
How do you know that?
Locker room talk.
I couldn't take that.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that to you. Yes, it is.
Do you read it a lot?
I've been reading that magazine since I was 15 years old.
15?
It has some good articles in it, too.
Sure.
Well, I'll talk to anyone.
Do you think this woman posing as a doctor?
I doubt it. She wouldn't need the money.
Well, maybe she didn't do it for the money. How much do they get paid?
I don't know, 10, 15 grand maybe.
That much?
Not bad for a day's work, huh?
You know, this one's body's no great shape. Look at that.
I don't believe what I'm hearing.
$15,000, huh?
These are hot.
Do you think so?
Mm-hmm.
You know, nobody's ever taken pictures this good of me before. Sissy, do you think I look sexy?
Are you kidding?
Okay, now, look at this.
Good grief. Look at her legs.
Her legs? Look at the rest of her.
Oh, well, that's abnormal. I mean, nobody looks like that. Do they?
She does. You know that they have done issues on women lawyers and doctors. They haven't done one on a policewoman.
Oh, you wouldn't do that. Would you? You would.
Why not? Now listen, look at these. I'm not getting any younger. And look at these pictures. I may never look this good again.
You have flipped. Oh, I love it.
The pictures you took of me.
You did?
Yeah, she wants you to take some of her.
Anytime.
Nick, do you think I look as good as some of those women in the magazine?
I think you look better.
No, come on now. I really want to know.
I'm serious. Why don't you believe me?
Well, I don't believe I look like that. I never thought of myself as sexy.
Are you kidding?
No.
I think you're the sexiest, most beautiful woman that I know. No doubt about it.
Really, Nick?
When I first met you, and you were in your uniform...
Yeah?
I thought I was going to make a fool out of myself. You just... You knocked me out.
Pull over. I got a mail sucker.
What?
There's a mailbox. Just pull over.
call, Mom. Let me help you.
Talk to your father. I'll do this.
So, Jen, finish that story about the kid with the knife.
Oh, yeah. Well, I screamed at him. And I said, put it down. Put down the knife, I mean it. And he didn't hear me. He didn't move at all. And then Nick tried to sneak up from behind, and I was really afraid that he was going to come for me. And he did. So I had to pull my gun on him.
All right.
Did you shoot him?
Jennifer, I really don't see why you have to tell these stories at the Sunday dinner table.
Well, Mom, you see, I was trying to tell them how I hardly ever draw my gun.
Did you kill him?
No, Tommy. I didn't kill him.
There's enough violence on television and in the newspapers. We don't need to hear these stories at the dinner table.
Well, Ma, a little blood and guts never hurt anyone.
That's enough, Skip. Let's have dessert.
Well, I gotta go. I got a date. It was nice to meet you, Nick. Hope to see you again.
Same here.
Bye, sis.
Bye.
Don't wait up for me, Mom.
Be careful, honey.
Betty, is the coffee ready?
It's coming.
Can I have some ice cream?
Sure. Come on.
Why does she do that, Dad?
Do what, honey?
You know what. She's always putting me down.
You're too sensitive.
Jen, maybe it wasn't the right time to tell that story.
Well, it never seems to be the right time, does it? Excuse me, I'm going to help her in the kitchen.
Look at that. Let's pick her up.
I know her. Let me talk to her. Jenny Oakes,
I can't believe it. Of all the cops to pick me up, it had to be you.
What are you doing out here?
What's it look like? Bet he knows what I'm doing.
I thought you moved to Chicago.
I did. Things didn't work out. So I came back.
I just can't believe you're doing this.
Oh, come off it, Jen. We always knew I'd end up doing something like this. I mean, really, what else would Fast Annie be doing? Teaching Sunday school?
That's not funny, Annie. There must be something else you can do.
You know, for a cop, you're pretty naive. And jobs don't grow on trees these days. I still can't believe you're a cop. You used to be afraid of your own shadow growing up.
Didn't keep me out of trouble, though,
did it? That's for sure. You got me in so much trouble, my mother tried to stop me from hanging around with you.
I'm just trying to help, Annie. I don't want to see them bring you in.
They gotta catch me first. Getting old. Well, we never thought that would happen, did we? How's the kid? He must be huge.
He's big. Listen, lady. I gotta get back to work. Now you get off the streets, okay?
See you later, Jen. Take care. Thank you.
You were friends?
Yep.
We used to read movie magazines and smoke cigarettes together down by the reservoir. We were always in trouble.
Come here. I'm gonna put green all over your face. Come here. What are we doing?
either.
Because I'm going to come back and I'm going to get you. All right?
Yeah.
Hello?
Jennifer Oaks, please.
Yeah, this is Jennifer Oaks.
Hi, I'm Margo Sim.
Who?
From Centerfold Magazine.
Oh, come on. Is this friend of Sissy's?
No, this is not a joke, I promise. My name is Margo Sims, and I'm the talent coordinator for Centerfold Magazine. We received your letter and your photos, and we're very interested in your suggestion for a policewoman pictorial.
I didn't think somebody was going to call me.
Actually, it's a great angle. Here's what we'd like to do. We'd like to bring you out here to Los Angeles for a test. There's no obligation whatsoever. We'll pay for everything. We'll show you around L.A. and take a few photos. We'll see how they turn out, and we'll take it from there.
Well, how long will it take?
Oh, just a couple of days. And we're prepared to pay you $25,000 for the layout in the event that we all decide to go ahead with this. How does that sound to you?
It sounds great. I'll just have to think about it, though, okay?
Oh, that's fine with us. You take your time, and you get back to us when you can.
I will. Yeah, great.
Terrific. I'll talk to you soon.
Yeah, goodbye. So anyway, that's what I did.
You did what?
I mailed the photographs you took of me to Centerfold. They called me this morning. They want me to come to Los Angeles for a test.
You mailed those photos to Centerfold Magazine?
Yeah. I did it for fun, you know. I don't know what really came over me. You know nothing's going to come of it.
That's convenient.
I didn't think they called me, Mick. You know, I've never done anything like this in my whole life.
Well, what are you going to do?
Go.
You're going to go?
Yeah, why not? I mean, I've never been to California. I've never been anywhere. And you know, as soon as I go out there, they'll just take one look at me and they'll forget the whole thing.
Why do you keep saying that? What are you trying to prove?
I'm not trying to prove anything. It's just a magazine. You read it. My brother reads it. Every cop on the force reads it.
And that's the point. And they don't want you to pose nude, Jenny.
There's nothing wrong with that. And they're going to do it in good taste.
Good taste? We're not talking about good taste. We're talking about you and me, not the rest of the world.
Look, I know what I'm doing, okay?
Yeah, well, explain it to me.
Well, I can't explain it to you. But it's important for me to do this. I know that. It's something I have to do.
Listen, things like this have a way of getting out of hand.
That won't happen.
Jen, forget it. Forget it. You do what you want.
Mick, come on. Let me talk to you.
Allied
flight 291. Oh, Sissy. I don't know about this. I feel like I could pass out any second.
Getting cold feet.
Oh, yeah. Honey, why don't you go in my place?
All right, I'm ready. Give me the ticket.
Oh, I wish you could. I am so scared. I figure once they see me, they'll figure they made a bad mistake.
Now, look, they said there was no obligation. And besides, you look great. They're going to love you.
Oh, do I? I mean, do I look like a hit from the sticks?
Well, yes. Oh, now, don't worry. You look great. They're going to love you. You're going to miss your plane.
Okay, Tommy, I want you to be good for Sissy now, okay?
Okay, but don't forget a present for me.
I won't, honey. All right.
Here, take that.
Sir?
Oh, Jen, do me a favor. Bring me back an Italian about 6 feet tall, great bod.
Well, I'll try my best.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you, too. Have fun.
I will. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye,
Tommy,
now.
You be good now.
Bye, Mommy.
Bye.
Love you.
Love you, too. You look great.
You look great.
All right.
All right.
Bye.
Bye
now.
Join Circus Hotel Casino with free Circus X daily, 11 a.m. to midnight. Play in our carnival arcade. Dine in the all-you-can-eat circus buffet. Try the 24-hour Pink Pony coffee shop. Enjoy the new Skyrise dining room or the pizzeria. And for casual fine dining, the steakhouse. Three snack bars, 2,800 luxurious rooms, plus the RV park linked by the sky shuttles. Visit the new Skyrise Tower, race and sportsbook, lounge, and a pool. Plenty of free covered parking. Join the fun at Circus Circus, midway on the Las Vegas Strip.
David Allen and Associates are tough lawyers. When David Allen and Associates defend your rights as an accident victim, it's only fair you know just how far we're willing to go to see you get all the money the law allows. David Allen and Associates. We help accident victims. Call 384-1115.
I think broadcasting is the best career anyone could have.
National's training is preparing me for an on-the-air job in radio.
National has lifetime placement assistance.
Maybe you have what it takes to succeed in broadcasting. Let National Broadcasting School send you a free brochure. National has financial aid available for qualified applicants. Take the first step to an exciting future. Call 737-9400. National Broadcasting School, 737-9400. That's 737-9400.
In the annals of great family adventure, there is one sweeping saga. And now, the adventure continues.
We have come for our horse.
The Black Stallion returns.
I know where the black is going, and I'm going after it.
When the mystical love of a boy and his horse becomes the chase of a lifetime.
You think you can bring the horse back across the desert on your own?
The saga, the adventure, the Black Stallion returns.
The TV5 movie, Thursday at 9.
It takes understanding to keep a family of kids together.
Brian, other people have to drink that milk too, you know.
That's why I'm leaving some.
It takes kindness.
I'm trying to think.
Maybe you'll have beginner's luck.
Devotion.
Anybody ever told you you're beautiful when you're wet?
And love toward brother and sister.
But you know how to knock.
Oh, sorry.
Life can get rough, but who says it can't be fun for one big family?
It's got everything.
Wednesdays at 7, right here on TV5.
Two episodes of MASH, weeknights at 6:30 and 7:30, right here on KBBU TV5.
Hello, I'm Margot Sims. We spoke on the phone. This is our photographer, Todd Walker.
Nice to meet you both.
How was your flight?
Fine, thank you.
You're even prettier than your pictures.
And you're so young.
Why, did I sound old on the phone?
Yes.
That was my serious business voice.
Now, I have some contracts for you to sign. I'm going to leave them with you so that you can look them over. And if you have any questions, you just call.
Remember, you have complete approval of the pictures before we run them. And there's absolutely no obligation for you to go through with the running of the pictures if you decide not to. I'll pick you up tomorrow morning at 9. Anything else?
Oh, Todd will describe the shoot to you. I wanted to have lunch with you today, but I just couldn't. Something came up. But Todd is not only a brilliant photographer, he's also a very nice man, so I know you're in good hands. Any questions?
I don't think so.
Tomorrow's shoot will be easy. It's not nearly as scary as it seems. Meanwhile, you relax and have some fun today.
Bye, Margo.
Have you seen much of L.A. yet?
No.
Would you like to take a short tour, then get a bite to eat?
I'd love it.
Good. Is this your first trip to L.A.?
Yeah, it's the first time I've been this far west ever. This is delicious.
I come here all the time. It's always good. You're gonna look great on film.
How do you know?
I've been doing this a long time. I know these things. Your coloring, the way the light looks on your face.
You know, I don't know if I'm doing the right thing.
What bothers you about it?
Well, I'm worried about what people think. You know, I come from a small town, and I have a little boy, and I am a police officer.
I know all that. But what it comes down to is, how do you feel about your body?
Why do you ask that?
Do you like the way you look?
Well, no, not really.
Then you're doing the right thing.
Why?
Because this experience will make you feel great about how you look and how you feel about your body. I've seen it happen time and time again.
Well, I hope you're right. It's in that pants back on.
Vince?
You know, Bob.
Todd. How have you been?
Fine.
How come every time I see you, you're with a beautiful woman?
I'm just a lucky guy, I guess. Please,
thank
Jennifer
you.
Oakes, Vince Ferragamo.
Hey, Jennifer.
Nice to meet you, Vince.
Oh, thank you.
You're my son's hero.
That's nice to hear. What's his name?
Tommy.
Tommy.
Would you mind...
Sure.
Oh, thank you. I'm sorry. He'd love this. I have a checkbook. There.
To Tommy.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Well, nice seeing you, Todd.
Nice to see you again, Vince. Hey,
very nice to meet you, Jennifer.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.
Tommy will just die when he sees this.
I propose a toast. To your first trip to Los Angeles, to fine wines, exquisite food, and to little boys' heroes.
Thank you.
tell Todd you're ready now.
Oh, wait a minute. Has anybody ever left at this point?
Well, a lot of strange things have happened around here. Don't worry. You're going to be just fine.
May I have a moment alone, please?
Sure.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, ladies. That'll be all for now.
The search for a better, healthier life is never ending. And the program that reveals where we are and where we're headed is LifeQuest. Now, LifeQuest shows you how to join this race for a longer life. Find out how medical advances are slowing the aging process, how living better can help you live longer, and what you can do now for a more satisfying old age in your future in Ageless America on LifeQuest.
Friday evening at 8, brought to you by the Heart Institute of Nevada.
Some people don't like to think about tomorrow, what they'll be doing, where they'll be going, and even more important, how they'll be feeling. Staying well, feeling good, enjoying life in good health, being able to enjoy the sunsets. The Heart Institute of Nevada knows this, and knows, too, you'll enjoy life more and live better with a healthier heart. Highly qualified cardiologists working together in Nevada's most complete cardiac care center, the Heart Institute of Nevada.
Hi there, laddies and lassies. Imperial Carpet announces a penny pincher of a carpet sale. If you be thrifty-minded, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to carpet your castle for a pittance. Saxony's, Berber's, footprint-free. The new miracle stain-resistant carpets. They're all on sale in your favorite shades. Cash in on these bonny savings. Take the high road, take the low road, but hurry to the penny pincher of a sale. On now at Imperial Carpet, 1954 South Main.
I'm standing here with Peter Minuet when he says to me, Senor Noggles, I just bought this whole island for $24. I said, you think that's a bargain?
You should try my new great steak burrito. Lots of marinated steak grilled with onions, homemade guacamole in a big tortilla for only $1.79.
Minuet said, fantastic. Do you have any more bargains? I said, well, I just happen to have this bridge.
Senor Noggles' new great steak burrito, now only $1.79.
Las Vegas, the city on the go 24 hours a day, the city that never sleeps. The home of the Lady Luck Dealing School. The Lady Luck Casino, a favorite in downtown Las Vegas, is the site of live casino training for those who qualify. You can learn to deal blackjack, craps, baccarat, roulette, and poker. Limited enrollment now available, but you must call now, 384-8045. Be a part of the excitement. Call now and see if you qualify.
She was the most popular female singer country music has ever known, single-handedly carrying country right to the top of the national charts.
She really changed people's thoughts of what a female singer in country music has to be.
25 years later, her music is as alive as ever. Now join Loretta Lynn, Sylvia, Dottie West, Mel Tillis, Ferlin Husky, and a host of Patsy's dearest friends as they present a loving tribute to the real Patsy Cline, featuring rare performances.
A TV5 special, Monday evening at 8.
Ta-da!
You look fantastic.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
Scared.
Oh, we'll take care of that. That's enough. It doesn't last very long. I'd like you to meet Alexis.
Hello.
And Adam.
Adam.
And we'll start right here. Adam, would you please get those extra film packs and put them on the rug? Right there. Alexis, move this back a little bit, please, and bring it down. These are your two key lights right over here.
Huh?
And they're going to help you enormously. So I'd like you to pay a lot of attention to them.
Okay.
All right? I want you to bring the chin down a little bit. I want you to move those knees over just a touch.
Like that?
That's it.
Oh, I'm
just
nervous.
Relax. Relax the hands, too.
Okay.
Let them be loose. Okay. That's lovely. Very nice. Very nice. Let's swing the legs around just a little bit. Just a little bit. Oh, lovely. Look at me. Yes. Up in the bed. Yes. Scoot back in the bed.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I've never done this before. A little slow to
I
catch up.
I get the feeling, yes. Okay. But you're doing just fine.
All right,
I want both those knees covered up first.
Okay.
Yeah, and I want to see just a little bit of the shoulder.
Okay.
Do that for
bit.
Me?
Uh-huh.
Just a little bit.
How's that?
That's beautiful. Yes, beautiful. I like it. Keep moving. Throw the head back. I like that. Throw the head back. Yeah? And look at me, can you, out of the corner of your eye?
Yeah.
Let me see that thigh.
Which one?
The top one.
Okay.
Yeah.
How's that? Too much?
No, that's fine. That's just fine. No, not for this side. This is great.
Okay.
Tuck the chin in just a little bit. Now look up here. Look up here. Chin down. That's beautiful. Have you done this before? No. You're wonderful. How do you feel?
Oh, I feel wonderful. Free. It's a wonderful feeling.
A celebration.
Champagne? Oh, what an idea. Thank
you. A toast to Jennifer. A beautiful and lovely lady. And a job well done.
Thank you. You know, I couldn't have done this without your help. Thank you.
I want you to know how lovely it was for me to work with you. I mean, you're a natural. You could make a great living at this if you wanted to. I just want you to know that if things get rough back home, or you need someone to talk to, or you just need to get away, I'm here for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you miss me?
Yes, Mom.
Yes?
Did you really meet Vince?
Yes, I did.
No one believes me.
Well, I'll tell you what. When we get you home, I've got something that's going to convince your friends. We'll show them, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Ferguson, you and Abbott take District 2. Nose around about that break-in at Howard's Pharmacy. See if you can come up with anything. Oakes, you're assigned to traffic today. Okay, that's it. Right. Let's go to work. Okay.
Yeah. Traffic?
Tough break.
I don't believe it. He treats me like I'm a rookie. He drives me crazy and he knows it.
Hey, officer.
Hi. Hi, Roy.
How you doing?
Real exciting. 3 tickets in 10 blocks.
We still on for tonight?
Yeah. I know Tommy wants pizza, and I thought we could...
Respond to a 211A, possible armed robbery in progress, 2943 West Grand.
10-4, we got it. I gotta go. See you later.
Bye.
Are you okay?
Not really.
What's wrong?
Nick, I'm in a rut. You know, I live in a trailer that leaks. And I'm not getting anywhere at work. I could be writing parking tickets for the rest of my life.
Hey, it's not L.A., but it's not that bad either.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I just had a really hard day, that's all.
I love you.
I love you, too. You gotta go.
For me. Now listen. Dear Jennifer, we love the photos. We'd like to run them in the next issue. Please call me so we can discuss this further. You look fabulous. I look forward to talking with you. Da-da-da. Sincerely, Margot Sims.
Oh, they want them!
Yeah.
Oh, well, I don't blame them. You look just beautiful.
Oh, Sissy, I can't believe it's me.
Oh, well, it's definitely you. Sure, there's your birthmark.
It's amazing how they made me look, huh?
I'll say. What a body. Oh.
What?
Well, this one's a little revealing, don't you think?
Well, there.
Hey, has Nick seen these yet?
Oh, yeah. You should have seen his face.
Oh, I wish I could have.
No, you don't.
Gee, Jen, what about your job? I mean, this could be big trouble.
Sissy, what can they do?
Well, they could make your life miserable, for one.
They can't really do anything. I haven't broken any rules or regulations.
Doesn't forgetting to wear your uniform break some kind of regulation?
Very funny.
These sure are sexy.
Come on, sis, you've seen photographs like this before.
Not of my best friend, thank you very much.
I'm still the same person.
Well, I guess so. Only now there's just a little bit more of you.
Nick? Nick, I want to get this stuff cleared up. I do.
I don't want to talk about it now, okay?
Okay. When? Because every time I want to talk to you about it, you say it's the wrong place or it's the wrong time. Now, Nick.
Come here.
I told you. I think they're too revealing. And I don't think they should be printed. And I think that you'll be sorry if they are.
I'll be sorry.
Hey, it's your body, not mine.
Yeah, you're right.
Whatever you do, you better get Buckman's permission first.
You know what I don't understand? I don't understand why your attitude on this whole thing has changed so much.
Hey, my attitude hasn't changed at all. It's been your decision all along.
But I want your support.
I don't know if I can give it to you, Jen. I just don't feel right about it. I'm sorry.
No, I'm addressing the PTA that night. Yes, Sonny, you'll be fine. Take care of this. What's on your mind, officer?
I have a request, sir.
Come on, I don't have all day.
I've been offered, well, a magazine wants to do a story on me, sort of. And they've taken some pictures of me.
What kind of pictures?
They're for Centerfold magazine.
What? You're kidding, right?
I'm not kidding. And I would like permission to let them publish the pictures in the next issue.
Well, you got a lot of nerve.
I don't know what you mean.
You know exactly what I mean. You're one of two women on a police force of 160 men. You're damn lucky to be here at all. And you think that I'm going to give you permission to pose nude in a girly magazine and continue to represent this police force? Absolutely not.
You never liked me. You never wanted me on this force, and you've never accepted that I can do the job.
Well, you never prove yourself to me this way.
I have already proven myself. I am a good officer.
What kind of a woman are you, anyway?
I earn the right to be on this force, and I intend to stay on it. The thing that really bugs you is that you don't have anything on me. Compared to half the officers on this force, I'm a dream cop. Sir. Margo! Yeah, it's Jennifer. I want to do it. Yeah. No, they can't do anything to me. I haven't done anything wrong. Thank you. Bye.
This was me when I believed I could keep my carpet clean better and cheaper myself. Well, if you've ever cleaned your carpet yourself, you'll understand how I felt when I found that Dunright will professionally clean the carpet in your living room, dining area, and hall for only $29.95. And that's a deep down clean with their dual method shampoo and steam cleaning. You really can't clean it as well yourself for that price. And since I don't have to do any of the work, I can have my carpets cleaned more often. Call Dunright, the dual method carpet cleaners.
Ever since they discovered silver in Virginia City, folks been coming to Nevada to strike it rich. Well, the first thing I discovered is you gotta have insurance. Lucky for me, the next thing I discovered is Nevada compulsory insurance. Heck, they get you insurance on the spot if you're young, old, or just roll into town. With all their different payment plans, you don't have to own a gold mine to afford it. Sit down, me and the old Mustang, and head on down the road knowing Nevada compulsory insurance has got us covered. Mind getting that horse away from my car?
Call now for a free rate quote. Nevada compulsory insurance, 733-1010.
Own 5 acres of land at Gateway Acres with no money down and only $79.30 per month. No qualifying, no credit check, no fees. And only 10 miles from Lake Mojave for the incredibly low price of $59.95. Breathe clean air on this fertile land where you can hunt, fish, and swim for only $79.30 per month. 10% interest included. Limited number available. So call International Land Sales at 796-4633 for full information and pictures.
Did you know that there are over 10,000 dealers working in Las Vegas casinos, most earning twice as much as the average income earned today? You could be a part of this exciting field. Hi, this is Gary Mahoney at the Opera House Dealer School, where you'll get the training you need to deal exciting casino games and earn a great living. Student loans and grants may even pay all the costs. Call now. Find out if you qualify for the career of the 80s. Visit the school and receive a free dinner for two at the Opera House Casino.
Sunday on 21 Jump Street.
You people have no idea what your kids are up to, do you?
Hanson and Penhall hunt for two free-spending teenage bandits.
We're living in penthouse suites, riding limos, buying motorcycles. We go home when the money's gone.
And on Married with Children, what is Al Bundy doing in Marcy's dream?
He asked me if I wanted to fool around.
Well, then what happened?
Nothing.
Yep, sounds like my Al.
Sundays on TV5. KPDU, TV5, Henderson, Las Vegas.
So I wanted you to hear this from me, and not from some kid at school.
What's the big deal?
Well, these pictures are going to be in a magazine that a lot of people can see. And, some people think I was wrong to do this.
What kind of pictures are they? Can I see them?
Well, they're really fun. You know, I mean, they're nice. But they're for grown-ups to look at.
When can I see them?
When you're older.
How old do I have to be?
Older. Like Skip's age.
Mom, that's forever.
Well, that's the way it is. Now, come on, finish your soda. Come on, I gotta take you to Sissy's because I gotta get back to work.
Okay.
Okay?
It's good to have you back, kid.
Well, if Michael hadn't been sick, I wouldn't have been assigned to you.
Well, you're twice the cop he is. So you think you made the right decision?
Well, as soon as Buckman said those things to me, that was it, you know? I knew exactly what I wanted to do. He made me so angry.
Well, if that hadn't happened with him, would you have made the same decision?
Oh, yeah.
If you wanted to now, could you stop it?
Why?
I've been thinking. Something like this affects a lot of people. Your parents, Tommy, me. And you'd also be jeopardizing your job. I don't know if it's worth the money.
Nick, I didn't do it for the money. I did it for me.
Unit 219-415F, Family Disturbance, 235 South Valley Drive.
I know who that is. Come on, let's go. Hi.
Hi. Can I help you with something?
Yeah. I'd like to buy a centerfold.
You mean you didn't get one free?
Yeah, but I want another one.
They're right here.
Oh, great.
Oh, it's on me.
Thanks.
You look great in there. You really do.
Oh, Lou, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
All right, knock it off. Knock it off in here. Smith and Billings, I want you to stake out that bar on 13th Street. Watch who comes and goes. Get a feel for its busiest hours. It may be the next place hit. All right, the department's taking up a collection for Officer Potter's widow. Donations can be left with Officer Gallo. Oaks, you're assigned to desk duty until further notice. All right, that covers it. Let's go to work.
Jen.
It's been better.
And don't let them get to you. You don't see him pass them the magazine, do you?
No.
Coffee?
Yeah.
And I'd like a bowl of soup. You don't want the soup? I'll get you a nice sandwich.
Okay.
Can I sit down?
Is Ellen watching?
No, Jen, I just want to warn you.
What? All the wives got a petition together to kick me off the force?
Hey, I'm trying to help you. Buckman's out to get you, and a lot of guys are just adding fuel to his fire.
I'll just bet.
I just want to let you know I'm behind you.
Isn't it a little late? Look, I appreciate it, okay?
I'll see you later, Jen.
Knock, knock.
Hi. Hey, honey, what brings you around here?
Oh, just felt like a visit.
Yeah?
Got any food?
Of course. There's some leftover chicken in the fridge.
Oh, great.
You know where everything is?
Yep. So, who's winning the war?
Oh, it's awful. It's just getting worse and worse. How do Mom and Dad feel about it?
Well, you know, Dad says about 3 words every 5 days, so he really hasn't had much to say about it. And Mama just gives her something else to worry about.
That sounds like her.
She had a pretty rough time at her bridge game the other night.
Oh, no.
You know, you're just going to have to take all the flack. I mean, there's nothing else you can do about it. You're tough. You can handle it.
What do you think?
I think it was a pretty crazy thing to do. But I also think you look great.
It doesn't embarrass you, then?
Oh, no. Some of the guys ribbed me about it a little bit, but hey, it's not every day your sister's in Centerfold.
Nick, hi.
How you doing?
All right.
Skip.
Excuse me. Hello? Todd, hi. How are you? Yeah, I'm fine. Yeah, I'm okay. Well, yeah, they're pretty upset. Oh, no. Oh, I wish I could, yeah, but it's a little fast out there for me. Yeah, I'm sure. Well, listen, thank you so much for calling. I appreciate it. Yeah. I will. Bye-bye. That was the photographer who had taken my pictures.
That's great. But does he have another job for you where you take your clothes off?
What's wrong, Nick?
Jen, I gotta go. Mom's got dinner waiting for me.
Yeah, bye, Skip.
I'll see you.
Mm-hmm.
Bye, Nick.
Yes.
something happen today?
Of course something happened today. You know, it's not just the cops, and they're having the time of their lives with this. It's the people on the streets, in the stores, the tellers at the bank, everywhere.
I'm sorry, okay?
Yeah, well, sorry doesn't make it. Why didn't you think about this? I tried to warn you, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
We have no privacy anymore. I feel invaded. Like our sex life is out on the newsstand or something.
Oh, that's not true. Now, come on. Are you that embarrassed?
Yes. People look at me funny, like I did something wrong. I don't know if I can handle this, Jen. I want to be able to, but I just don't know anymore. I'm just going to have to take some time and think about it.
Vic, is there anything that I can do?
No. I'll be in touch.
A special color presentation. Father of the Bride. A colorful guideline for wedding preparation.
How would you like to elope?
So get out that old tuxedo. Drop by the in-laws' house.
That is a shack.
And proudly march down the aisles. Spencer Tracy. Elizabeth Taylor. A special color presentation. Father of the Bride.
A special TV5 movie. Friday evening at 9.
Welcome to Tommy's for the finest ribs, steaks, and chicken in Las Vegas. At Tommy's, we make dining a pleasure, and it will be our pleasure to serve you real hickory smoked ribs, top quality steaks, and barbecue chicken. A taste treat you'll never forget. Right, Pop? Come in and join us for dinner soon. Remember, Tommy's is located at 1505 East Flamingo, 3 blocks east of Maryland. I'll be here to greet you or call me for your takeout order.
The deals are on now at the Dealer's Room Casino Clothiers. If you like Angel Flight, you'll love our own Dealer's Pants for men at an unbeatable $21.95. And for ladies at the Dealer's Room, lightweight pants from Pantasia. We're $34.95 now, $25.95. And as always, the latest styles and colors of tuxedos, starting at just $119. If you don't want to buy, no problem. We also rent the Dealer's Room Casino Clothiers and more in the Maryland Square Shopping Center and 4465 West Flamingo in Trams Plaza.
This is great. Thanks, Mary.
Sure.
Not long ago, I hired Mary from VTI. She knows everything about running my office using the computer.
And I was really bored with my old job. I knew there was no chance for career advancement without learning about computers. Then one day I saw a VTI commercial, and I decided to call.
And I'm glad she did. Mary's training lasted for less than a year. She went to VTI's night classes.
And I was eligible for financial aid.
And their career placement department really worked. They called me to let me know about Mary. You know, there's thousands of computer careers just waiting for somebody like you. But you'll need training. Call VTI and get hands-on training.
You really should. The number is 877-3626.
Call VTI. Careers are available. One could be for you. Call right now. 877-3626. You'd be glad you did.
Meet Matisse. He's no ordinary dog.
My favorite pooch.
Matisse lives in Beverly Hills.
Puppy pate for the discerning doggy.
He's well-bred. Well-read. And he has a 4 handicap.
What do you expect from a dog who sees a therapist twice a week?
Too bad, pup.
Matisse is down and out in Beverly Hills.
Saturday on TV5.
Come in.
You wanted to see me, sir.
Sit down. Officer Oakes, I've asked for a formal board of inquiry into your recent behavior. As of today, you're suspended indefinitely from this police force.
On what grounds?
Conduct unbecoming an officer, among other things.
What? Conduct unbecoming an officer?
That's right. And if I have anything to say about it, you'll never wear another police uniform again. Now give me your gun and your badge.
There are officers on this force who openly cheat on their wives. I know, and you all know, officers who pick up prostitutes and not for arrest. And you call what I've done conduct unbecoming an officer. These men have hurt other people, and I haven't hurt anybody. What I did on my own time. And it only has to do with me. Am I excused now?
Yes, you are.
Behavior. Coming from those guys, that's a joke.
I can't believe it's gone this far.
I don't know why you're so surprised.
What do you mean?
Jennifer, you pose nude in a national magazine. You're a police officer in a small conservative town. What did you expect?
I didn't expect for them to threaten to take away my job.
Look, Jennifer, we're not in high school anymore. It's not like you're going to be kicked off the cheerleading team.
Well, I know that, sissy.
You might be kicked off the police force. I just don't think you're being realistic about this.
Thanks for all your support. I'll see you later.
The morning papers. I'm sorry, Mom. You go ahead.
No, you go. I'm really sorry about all this hurting you. You know, I really am. But there's nothing I can do. I feel awful. Do you know that?
Oh, baby. You're beautiful. God gave you a beautiful body, and you have nothing to be ashamed of. Don't look back. You just have to go on from here. Fight them. I've never known you not to fight back.
I think this time I went a little too far.
Nonsense. I just want you to give up. Don't you do that.
Oh, Mom. Mm. Oh, Mom.
There's the cape.
Yeah. Hey.
Look at this.
What do you think you're doing?
You know, it was okay for you to get in that fight. I just wish you hadn't been put in a position of defending me.
I didn't get into a fight, Mom. They beat me up. Why did you have to do it?
Because I wanted to.
Why?
Honey, sometimes we do things for reasons that only make sense to us, you know, and they don't make sense to other people. But we just go ahead and we do them anyway. Can you understand that?
I don't know.
When you grow older, there's going to come a time when you do something that I'm not going to agree with. And I just hope that I can understand that the decision you made was the right one for you. I should have shown you the pictures. Now, that was a mistake. Oh, honey. I am so sorry that all this has happened. You know, I wouldn't do anything in the world to hurt you. You know that, don't you?
Yeah.
Don't you ever forget it. Because I love you very much.
I love you too, Mom. What are you going to be if you can't be a policeman anymore?
I don't know. What do you think I should be?
A fireman.
Well, I think I'd have a little trouble getting that job.
Mom?
Yeah.
I thought your pictures looked pretty.
Oh, Tommy. Thank you. Now, come on, let's have some dinner so we can have some of that ice cream, okay? Ketchup. Some mustard, too?
Yeah.
Well, I'll certainly do the best I can for you. Right now, I'm waiting to hear if the city manager will hear your case. As long as the Internal Affairs Division has the case alone, you don't stand a snowball's chance in hell. I mean, they really want your hide. They're not only saying conduct on becoming an officer. Now they're saying something about laws on the books, not being able to take another job without good reason and without having written permission from the captain, which you didn't get.
When will we hear if the city manager's going to hear the case?
Hard to tell. Week, two, maybe three. Part of the problem is this whole thing has caused quite a stir in the community. Everybody's taking sides, speaking out. It's raising all kinds of issues. Sexism, women's rights, hypocrisy, you name it. Some of that is good for us.
But I'd keep a low profile if I were you. At least until we know better what we're up against.
Okay.
Listen, I want you to remember one thing. You haven't done anything wrong.
Thank you for your help.
Don't thank me yet. In the meantime, let's just hope for the best, and I'll be in touch.
Thank you.
You're gonna nail her.
What do they got her on?
You name it. Moral misconduct, insubordination, improper dress. Whole list of things.
Is that enough to be dismissed?
It is if they want it to be. But she really lost it when they suspended her. Serves a broad right. What the hell does she think she is anyway?
I thought she looked pretty good. I wouldn't mind a little of that action.
Hey, you better keep your foul mouth shut, man. I'm gonna break your head. You get my drift?
Come on, get out of here.
Come on. All right. I don't want to hear another word from any of you guys.
Okay, okay.
Surrounding the indefinite suspension of Officer Jennifer Oates for posing in this month's Centerfold magazine widened today when Captain David Buckman announced he was asking a permanent dismissal of Miss Oates from the Lambert Police Force. An internal board of inquiry has been called to review all sides of this unusual case. In other news, the president made a quick stop in...
Organized crime. The words conjure up images of Tommy guns, bathtub gin, and Scarface Al Capone. Today there's a new mafia that includes dozens of different ethnic underworld groups. Jamaican hitmen, Colombian coke dealers, Asian sex slavers. Organized crime is a billion-dollar business and it's everywhere. I'll take you face-to-face with some of today's most notorious mobsters, the sons of Scarface.
Monday evening at 9.
The Constitution, brought to you by The Carpet Barn with Oscar Goodman.
The purposes of the Constitution, as expressed in its preamble, were to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty. In human terms, the desire to establish justice and secure the blessings of liberty are the ultimate goals of the Constitution. Government efficiency, international influence, domestic order, and economic needs are all important. But none exceeds justice and liberty as the essence of our constitutional commitment to the people of the United States.
The Constitution, brought to you by The Carpet Barn.
The Carpet Barn is a name that you've trusted and relied on for generations.
The Carpet Barn not only has quality carpet at the lowest prices, but has the largest selection of styles and colors of Congoleum No-Wax Seamless that is easy to install as 1, 2, 3. And it's easy to maintain and stays new-looking for years. Buy today, we install tomorrow. For a free estimate in your home, call 384-8551.
Starting a new career can sound a lot more difficult than it really is. In fact, you can start your new career in just one phone call. You see, we have trained thousands of students just like you to become well-paid casino dealers. There are positions just waiting, and we help place each student in their first job. Plus, government financial assistance is available. Starting your new career can be just a phone call away. Call International Dealer School today, 733-9133.
Dear Caleb, the biggest news round these parts is Pepperidge Farm's new American collection. Big, generous cookies, simply bursting with lumpy, bumpy personality. Whopping chunks of rich chocolate and nuts are hidden beneath each lump and bump. My favorites are the Chesapeake and the Sausalito. Why, they've got more personality than most folks we know.
Saturday. The night begins with action and adventure. Now, terror strikes at a new time. Werewolf is on the move and taking over the start of Saturday night. Then, Beans has a date with a college co-ed in danger.
Feds are looking for me, Mary Ellen.
Look, guys, I gotta be home by 11 or my mom is gonna shoot me.
I'll take care of it for her.
Saturday on TV5. Every day is Mother's Day with Mama's Family. Tuesdays at 7 p.m.
Like that. I'm sorry.
Nick, please, I don't...
Look, just let
you.
Me finish. I've been walking around the last 2 weeks like a zombie. All I've been thinking about is you. You and me. And that's all that matters, is you and me. I love you. And I want to marry you.
Nick, you have terrible fun. I mean, look at my hair and I'm...
Hey, would you marry me, please?
I wanted you to ask me that question since I first met you. And now, you know this is really a tough time for me right now. And I've got to sort some things out. You know, I have to get my job back. That's very important to me. And I can't marry you right now while I'm going through all this. I don't think it's fair. Can you wait?
I can wait as long as it takes.
Centerfold. Yeah. Well, look, we think what you did is fine, just fine. We really do. Thank you. Well, I really hope you get your job back. I mean, they had no right to fire you. I hope I get it back, too. Well, bye now. Bye. And good luck. Thank you.
Hey,
I saw another one of those billboards today.
Yeah, me too.
How are my chances looking this week?
Oh, Nick. I'm still feeling so frustrated.
Not so good, huh?
I feel like I'm in limbo. I feel like if I don't get my job back, I'm going to have to look for something else. And you don't want a wife without a job, do you?
I want you any way I can get you.
I love you. I promise it'll be soon.
That's what we're still trying to get the city to rule on your case. First Amendment rights violation is the way it's being presented.
How long is it going to take?
I'm bringing the case up tomorrow. Right now, the chances are 50-50 of you getting your job back.
Okay, I understand.
Look, Jen, I'll try my best. Just keep your fingers crossed.
Bye. Thanks, Steve.
Bye.
Come here. Let me make sure your hair is okay. You'll be good.
Okay.
Okay. Bye.
Bye, Mommy!
Oh, bye, Tommy.
Oh,
The polls are in for Mr. President. The LA Times reports that the Fox series amuses without being silly. The New York Daily News says no actor is better suited to become president than George C. Scott. Scott gives the role strength and depth, says the Christian Science Monitor. Variety says Mr. President has an edge of wisdom. The LA Daily News, White House residents have never been so appealing. And the New York Post says Scott's comic timing is superlative.
Ain't politics grand.
Sundays on TV5.
How much?
What do you want to pay?
$100?
I got $100. Do I hear $125?
At some discount stores, you have to haggle to take home a great deal. But at Silo, you don't have to because everything's on sale. Every TV, every VCR, every stereo, even every appliance. And you don't need to raise your voice or even your finger.
Sold to the Lipton Lord for $200.
Let's go to Silo.
There's no sale like a Silo sale.
Good morning, Las Vegas.
This could be you. You might have what it takes to be a professional disc jockey, newscaster, or sportscaster. To find out, call National Broadcasting School for a free brochure, 737-9400. Financial aid is available for qualified applicants. And National's Placement Assistance Program will help you find your first job.
I think broadcasting is the best career that anyone could have.
Call right now, 737-9400. National Broadcasting School, 737-9400.
If you've been hurt in an accident, you need the lawyers at David Allen & Associates now. You need David Allen to get you cash for your lost income, cash for your medical expenses, cash for your hardship. David Allen & Associates are tough, smart lawyers who mean business. David Allen & Associates, we help accident victims. Call 384-1115.
Can America best the rest? Find out on the ultimate countdown of the world's finest hotels, restaurants, beaches, and resorts. The stars raise the flag for America in a spectacular two-hour extravaganza. It's a non-stop journey of excitement around the world in pursuit of excellence. Don't miss the sizzling showdown on the all-new countdown of the rich and famous 1987 World's Best. Can America best the rest? The verdict is near.
Don't miss this TV5 special, Wednesday evening at 9. At 3:30, She-Ra battles the forces of evil, and you'll laugh while learning the facts of life at 4. But now, stay tuned for the Smurfs, next on KBBU.